Greetings and welcome to this lecture of refrigeration and air conditioning. We will continue with the numericals related to air conditioning system design. So here you can see a diagram has been shown. We have already seen this diagram. This diagram is very important. Here, suppose for example, an office room is shown. So this diagram indicates what are the cooling load components. Okay, different type of heat entering the room, which needs to be removed by air conditioning system. Okay, so whatever sensible heat part of the heat is there in the room, that is called room sensible heat, and whatever latent heat part is there, that is called room latent heat. Okay, so here you can see different sources are there: solar gain through glass, okay, heat gain through glass, then conduction is there, then from exterior wall, floor, roof and partition wall also the heat will enter. Partition wall meaning, suppose beyond this wall there is another room, so that room is not air conditioned and this room is air conditioned, so there will be heat transfer from higher temperature to lower temperature. So this is the partition wall. Then internal equipments are there, lighting, then computer is there, printer is there. Okay, all these things will form load. Then infiltration of air, there will be gaps in windows, in doors, from there the air will infiltrate. So these are different sources of sensible heat and latent heat inside the room. Now what are the sources of sensible heat? Through glass, wall, roof, partition wall, ceiling, floor, infiltration, internal heat gain from people, power, lights, appliances, additional heat gain which we can consider using safety factor, etc. So these are sources of sensible heat and sources of latent heat. What do you mean by latent heat? Latent heat means moisture content. Okay, you can consider for human being, there will be perspiration, sweating, then infiltration air, it will also have moisture content. Then suppose steam is there, due to some process steam is there, so that steam will form the latent heat load, then vapor transmission, etc. So these are the sources of latent heat inside a room. So after this, we have already seen this part as well, room sensible heat factor. What is that? Room sensible heat factor is room sensible heat upon room total heat equal to room sensible heat upon room sensible heat plus room latent heat. Okay, now what is meaning of this? Here I have explained it with the help of a diagram. In this diagram, we assume that mixing is done before the cooling coil. So one is the outside air or ventilation air, it mixes with the recirculated air. This 0.2 is the at room design condition, it mixes with the outside air. We will get 0.3, which is mixing condition. Then there is a cooling coil whose surface temperature TS is coil ADP, it is 0.C. Okay, and the coil will have some bypass factor. Then there will be cooling from 0.3 to 0.4, and 0.4 is the supply air condition. That supply air is sent to the room. Now this supply air, it should pick up the required sensible heat, room sensible heat and required room latent heat. So how is this taken into account, that 0.4 is able to pick up room sensible heat and room latent heat with the help of RSHF line? So after calculating room sensible heat factor using sources of heat, okay, there you will get sources of sensible heat, sources of latent heat, okay, and from there we can find out room sensible heat upon room sensible heat plus room latent heat, RSHF. Now what is the next step? RSHF point, it is marked on sensible heat factor scale, that is suppose point A. Then we connect it with alignment circle, that is point B. Alignment circle meaning 25 degree dry bulb temperature, 25 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 50% RH. So this line is called baseline. Now point number two, if you see the previous diagram, point number two, this is room design condition. We draw from point number two RSHF line. How to draw RSHF line? Draw a line parallel to baseline passing through room design condition point two. Wherever it intersects the saturation curve, there we will get room ADP. Now supply point, point number 4 or S, it should lie on RSHF line. Why? Because this baseline and RSHF line, we have calculated using the ratio RSHF equal to RSH upon RTH. So we have already taken into account the sources of sensible heat and latent heat. Using that, we got a factor we marked over here. And using that, we got a particular slope of a line. Okay, this line has a particular slope. So if the supply point, that is point S or point 4, if this supply point, if it lies on RSHF line, it will pick up the required room sensible heat and room latent heat. So this is the, here the method is written how to draw this RSHF line. This we have already seen. Next we will see grand sensible heat factor. Now grand sensible heat factor, what is meaning of that? There will be room sensible heat and outside air is entering, and both will form the cooling load on this coil. Okay, so if heat load includes outdoor load in addition to room load, then the cooling coil is required to handle grand total heat load. Okay, so what is grand sensible heat factor? It is defined as ratio of total sensible heat to grand total heat. So grand sensible heat factor is total sensible heat upon grand total heat, and grand total heat is total sensible heat plus total latent heat. What is total sensible heat? Room sensible heat plus outside air sensible heat. And what is total latent heat? It is room latent heat plus outside air latent heat. Next is effective room sensible heat factor. Now understand this effective room sensible heat factor. This is ratio of effective room sensible heat upon effective room sensible heat plus effective room latent heat. Okay, now what is effective room sensible heat? Effective room sensible heat is room sensible heat. Here you can see same diagram has been shown. So this is RSH, room sensible heat plus bypass factor into outside air sensible heat. Now what happens here? The outside air, it mixes with recirculated air, and the mixing condition is 0.3, and that 0.3 air, it enters the apparatus where cooling coil is there, and it gets cooled and dehumidified, and we get point number 4. Now here you can understand that point 2, it is already at room design condition, so it will not form any load on cooling coil. But if you consider outside air, it will have outside air sensible heat, outside air latent heat. Okay, now since there is some bypass factor of the cooling coil, what is the effective room sensible heat in this room? It will be room sensible heat plus outside air sensible heat into bypass factor. This bypassed air cooling coil, there will be some bypass, and that bypassed air, it will form the load for this 0.4 supply air. So this supply air 4, it should pick up the room sensible heat as well as bypass factor into outside air sensible heat. Similarly, this 0.4 supply air, it should pick up room latent heat plus bypass factor into outside air latent heat. Now how to find outside air sensible heat and outside air latent heat? Since this is outside air, okay, we have point number 1. Point number 1 is shown over here. Then using the given data, point number 1 properties are given. Suppose in the this we know, we can measure the atmospheric temperatures. We can mark point number 1 on psychrometric chart. Room design condition, meaning what the customer wants inside the particular room. Okay, so that conditions are also fixed. So we can mark 0.2, we can draw 1 to 2. Then drop vertically downward line from 0.1 and draw a horizontal line towards right from 0.2. Wherever they intersect, we get 0.8. Okay, now since this is outside air sensible heat, outside air latent heat, mass flow rate will be mass flow rate of dry air of entering air, that is 0.1 in both the case. Now 8 to 2 dry bulb temperature is changing, so this will be related to outside air sensible heat. So m dot da1 into ha minus h2 will give outside air sensible heat. Next, when you say outside air latent heat, it will be m dot da1 outside air mass flow rate, 0.1 dry bulb temperature and 0.8 dry bulb temperature, they are same, so this part is latent heat part. Outside air latent heat, it will be equal to m dot da1 into h1 minus ha. Okay, So this is about outside air sensible heat and outside air latent heat. Okay. Now using bypass factor, we can get ERSH, ERLH. Substitute in this equation, you will get effective room sensible heat factor. Okay. So effective room sensible heat factor here, outside air, which is mixed. Okay. Here you can see 0.1, which is mixed with the return air. Okay. That is outside air is called ventilation, can be studied thermodynamically as independent entity. Now bypass factor of outside air adds sensible heat and latent heat load to the room. However, the bypass factor of return air, okay, this is the return air 0.2, has no effect because it is already at room condition. So that is why we have found effective room sensible heat factor. Okay, what is the effective room sensible heat on this room, in this room, and what is the effective room latent heat? Okay. That there we consider room sensible heat plus the sensible heat which is added to the room because of the bypass of the outside air. Same way, effective room latent heat will be room latent heat plus whatever air is bypassed, outside air, its latent heat. Okay, this we consider while calculate effective room sensible heat factor. This is one more method of finding outside air sensible heat and outside air latent heat. Okay, now coming to the actual concept of ERSHF, what happens here, we will see that. Okay, now understand this upper diagram. Okay, this diagram we have already seen schematic of the setup. Okay, now what happens, 0.1, it is outside air. Okay, it will come over here. This is the AC apparatus, meaning the cooling coil, and some of the air is bypassed. Okay, it depends on what bypass factor. So some air is bypassed and some air, it goes to the cooling coil. Okay, outside air. Then this is point number two, which is return air. You can see this is return air. Okay, now this is the AC apparatus. Now what will happen? You can see this is the 0.4, which is supply point. This is the supply point. Air is supplied to the room. That point is 0.4. Now what happens here, after the cooling coil, instead of getting 0.4, we get 0.4 dash. Okay, now this 4 dash air, it mixes with 1 air. Okay, we can consider it like this. Actually, they have already mixed. Okay, but here I have shown equivalent circuit for bypassed outside air. So some air bypasses. Okay, if you are considering outside air mixes with recirculated air. 0.3 is what? Mixed air. Now this 0.3 air, it will enter the cooling coil. Some air is bypassed. So I have shown here, some air is bypassed directly the cooling coil. Okay, AC apparatus means cooling coil. So what will happen? Instead of getting 0.4, we get 0.4 dash. Now this 4 dash and 1, okay, meaning bypassed air, they mix together and we get point number 4. Okay, now same thing you have to observe here. Okay, what is that? Here you can observe 1 and 2 mix to give 0.3. Okay, then here you can see next thing, after 2 we have 4 dash point. Okay, on the bottom side you can see that 4 dash point, it will lie on which line? ERSHF line. Then 2 room ADP, that is RSHF. Okay, on that we have supply point, point number 4. And 3-2C is GSHF line, and supply point, point number 4 should lie on both the line, GSHF as well as RSHF, and that is visible over here. Okay, now next point is, here you can see that 1 and 4 dash, they mix together and we get 0.4, and same you can see in the diagram as well. This is 0.1, this is 0.4 dash. They mix and in between you get 0.4. Okay, now we are talking from the ERSHF line point of view. Okay, we have already seen how to mark 0.4 using RSHF and GSHF line. Now suppose GSHF line is not available to us. Okay, what we are talking about, GSHF line is not available. We have ERSHF line, we have RSHF line. Okay, from there we need to draw GSHF line. How to draw that? That we are looking at. Okay, so 1 and 4 dash. 4 dash is there on ER-SHF line. This is ER-SHF line. They will mix and we will get point number 4, and that is supplied to the room. That will pick up the required room sensible heat and room latent heat. Now here you should understand that the condition of air at point 4, it is able to balance. This point 4 is on RSHF line. It is able to balance room sensible heat and room latent heat. Okay, and point 4 lies on RSHF line. But if you consider point 4 dash, it lies on ER-SHF line, which is 2 to C, coil ADP, and it is able to balance the bypassed outside air sensible heat and latent heat in addition to the room load, that is room sensible heat plus room latent heat. That is the meaning of this diagram. Okay, now here what we can do, we can consider the two triangles. Okay, two triangles are C4, 4 dash, and next triangle is C3, 2. Okay, now in actual case, here what happens, this distance between 4 dash and 0.4, it is so small, we will see this in numerical, it is so small that you can consider that instead of drawing 4 dash to 1, you can draw from 4 dash parallel to 2, 3. Okay, so this, instead of drawing 4 to 4 dash, which is connecting point 1, what we will do? We will draw a line like this. Just a minute, I'll draw the line first. Now, we can draw this line in such a way that this line will pass through point 4 dash and it is parallel to 2, 3. It will intersect the RSHF line and there we will mark point number 4. How we can do that? This error is negligible. Why? Because the distance between 4 dash and 4, it is very negligible. So this type of approximation is done. Okay. So what we will do, if suppose we don't have GSHF line, okay, and we are able to somehow calculate ERSHF. So we will draw ERSHF line using bypass factor. Okay, what is bypass factor? Actual equation is, it is length 4C upon length 3C. Now, since triangle C4, 4 dash and triangle C3, 2, they are similar triangle, we can write even length C4 dash upon length C2. That is also bypass factor using similar triangle property. Okay, so if ER-SHF line is there and bypass factor is given, we can mark point 4 dash, then draw from 4 dash a line which is parallel to 2, 3. Wherever it cuts RSHF line, there we will draw point, mark point 4. Now this is approximation. Okay, actually what will happen, this 4 dash, it will be joining with 1. Okay, and that location will give point 4. But then in that case, we are not able to actually get this bypass factor. Okay, we will not be able to mark the bypass factor because we don't have two similar triangles. So here one small approximation is done. What is that? Since the distance between 4 dash and 4, it is very small. Instead of joining 4 dash and 1, we draw from point 4 dash a line which is parallel to 2 to 3. Okay, so this we will see in next slide. Now here you can see, this is outside air, point 1, it mixes with room design condition, we get point 3. 3 to C is GSHF line, okay, that line suppose we don't have. So what we will do, we will somehow get ER-SHF, that data might be given, we will draw 2C. Then using bypass factor, we will get point 4 dash. Now draw a line parallel to 2, 3 passing through point 4 dash. Wherever it cuts RSHF line, there we will get point 4. Now you have to draw a line from point C and point 4, extend it to line 1, 2. Wherever it cuts the line 1, 2, there you will get mixing point 0.3. Okay, so same thing is written here. 4, 4 dash is parallel to 1, 2 or 2, 3. Since triangle C, 4 dash, 4 is similar to triangle C, 2, 3, we can write length C4 ओके, और लेंथ 4c अपॉन लेंथ 3c दैट इज बाईपास फैक्टर इक्वल टू लेंथ 4 डैश c अपॉन लेंथ 2c. ओके, इन दिस वे वी हैव टू गेट पॉइंट 4 डैश यूजिंग द बाईपास फैक्टर इक्वेशन. नाउ वी विल सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल रिलेटेड टू दिस. Now, how to identify this type of question? Okay, this is the question given. Now, how to identify whether you have to find 0.4 dash and from there you have to get 0.4. How to identify that? Here, what is the data given? Ventilation air, meaning outside air is given. Okay, point number one, ventilation air is given. Okay, which is 40 cmm, 40 cubic meter per minute. And bypass factor is given. If you see the previous numericals which we have solved, there what data was given? There either mixing proportion was given, here mixing proportion was given, meaning m dot da1 is suppose 40% of m dot da3, like that it was given. But here what is given? We don't know the percentage of outside air or recirculated air. Here what is given? Directly ventilation air volume flow rate is given, meaning v dot a1 is given. Whenever v dot a1 is given, okay, and a bypass factor is given, in this case you have to solve using that ER-SHF line concept. Okay, so we will see the numerical, how to solve this numerical step by step. So let me explain the numerical, then step by step you have to solve the numerical on your side. So what is given in the question? Room sensible heat gain is given. Okay, so RSH is given, 42 kilowatt. Then room latent heat is given, 12.5 kilowatt. After that, room design condition, 0.2 is given, properties of 0.2. Outside design condition, dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature of 0.1 is given. Then after that, ventilation air, that is V dot A1 is given. Okay, this is V dot A1. Then next, bypass factor is given. So again, here, since ventilation air is given, we will calculate ERSHF. Okay, why? Because we cannot get mixing point, point number 3. Mixing proportion is not given. So we cannot, if we cannot see, this is 0.1, this is 0.2, that mix together to give 0.3. Now, we cannot mark 0.3, so you cannot approximately, suppose this is RSHF line, okay, through 0.2, you cannot, in previous numerical what you used to do, approximately you used to adjust the bypass factor, length 4C upon length 3C, that you used to approximately take what is given in the question, bypass factor. But here, we don't have point number 3, we cannot calculate that. So what we will do, we will make use of this ventilation air data to get ERSHF. Okay, understand what I have done here. So we will see the steps. So first we have to mark 0.1 and 0.2 based on the given data. So we will go to the psychrometric chart. 0.1, it is given at 36 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 26 degree Celsius wet bulb temperature. So this is point number 1. Next, point number 2, it is given at 24 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 50% RH. So 24 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 50% RH. So this is point number 2. Here you can see RH is 50%. This is 50% RH. Okay. Then what about the different lines? Okay, we'll quickly revise that. Vertical lines are dry bulb temperature lines. Horizontal line, wherever it cuts the saturation curve, there you can read dew point temperature. On right side, wherever it cuts the y-axis, there we have to read moisture content. Inclined lines are wet bulb temperature lines, where it cuts the saturation curve. And beyond saturation curve, on this scale, you can read specific enthalpy. Okay, these are relative humidity curves and this one is saturation curve. Relative humidity is 100%. So we have marked 0.1, we have marked 0.2, we cannot mark 0.3. right now. Okay, what will be the next step? Okay, here you can see there are two baselines. One baseline is for ERSHF, one baseline is for RSHF. Okay, and there you can see the distance. They are very close to each other. Even here you can see ERSHF line and RSHF line. They are very close to each other. Okay, so there will be definitely variation in answer. We will see this part. Okay, now what you have to do? Whenever ventilation is air is given, okay, here you can see I have drawn vertically downward line from point 1 and horizontal line towards right from point 2. Wherever they intersect, I have marked point A. Okay, then you have to read enthalpy of point 1. What is that enthalpy? We will see that this is 80 and this is 80.5. So enthalpy of point 1 is 80.5. Then enthalpy of point A, that we have to read. What is that value? This is 60 and this is 61. So enthalpy of point A, it is 61 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Then after that, we have to read enthalpy of point 2. What is that? 45, 46, 47, 48.5. Okay, so H2 is 48.5 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Now what we can do, since point 1 is outside air, okay, and capital V dot A1 is given, okay, we can read specific volume of point 1 and find M dot dA1. Then since we have H1, HA and H2, we can find outside air sensible heat, outside air latent heat, bypass factor is given in the question, okay, and RSH and RLH is given. So basically we can find ERSHF using this. So we will see this part now. Okay, so we'll go to the calculation part now. Okay, so we have marked point 1 and 2. Okay, then we have joined 1 and 2 and read the value of H1, HA and H2. Okay, now what is outside air sensible heat? It is M dot dA1 outside air mass flow rate into HA minus H2. Okay, here temperature is changing. Okay, outside air sensible heat. Then in that, this M dot dA1 is not known. Okay, so how to calculate M dot dA1? It will be V dot A1 upon specific volume of 0.1. What is V dot A1? It is 40 cubic meter per minute. Convert this to seconds. 40 divided by 60. Okay, so that value you will get 2 by 3 divided by specific volume of 0.1. We have to read from psychrometric chart. So from 0.1, you can see I have drawn a specific volume line. These are specific volume lines. Okay, and I can read the value of specific volume of 0.1. It is 0.899 meter cube per kg of dry air. Okay, so substitute that value there. Okay, so here I have substituted the value of specific volume and I can calculate M dot dA1. Okay, what is the unit of that? Kg of dry air per second. Okay, and magnitude is 0.74156. Now, HA value we have read, H2 value we have read and H1 value also we have read. So, we can calculate outside air sensible heat. Okay, so outside air sensible heat is mass flow rate of dry air into HA minus H2. We will get outside air sensible heat. Then outside air latent heat, what will be that? It will be M dot dA1, okay, mass flow rate of outside air into H1 minus HA. M dot dA1 we have calculated over here. H1 and HA value we have read. So we will get outside air latent heat. Now bypass factor, it is given in the question 0.15. Okay, RSH is 42 kilowatt, RLH is 12.5 kilowatt. So we can find effective room sensible heat factor. Okay, so here you can see I have found effective room sensible heat factor. What is that? Room sensible heat plus bypass factor into outside air sensible heat. Substitute the values. Room sensible heat is 42 plus bypass factor 0.15 into outside air sensible heat. We will get ERSH in kilojoule per second or kilowatt. Then effective room latent heat, what will be that? Room latent heat plus bypass factor into outside air latent heat. Okay, so room latent heat is 12.5 kilowatt plus bypass factor into outside air latent heat. So we will get effective room latent heat, which is 14.669 kilojoule per second or kilowatt. So now we can calculate effective room sensible heat factor. What is that? Effective room sensible heat upon effective room sensible heat plus effective room latent heat. That value is 0.747, approximately equal to 0.75. Okay, now here comes the difference between the previous numericals. Now what we have to do, understand that. We'll go to the psychrometric chart. What is the value which we calculated? We calculated ERSHF value. What was that? We'll see the value. ERSHF value, it is 0.75. Okay, so we'll go to the psychrometric chart. Here you can see, this is sensible heat factor scale. Okay, on sensible heat factor scale, we have to mark 0.75. So this is 0.75. Okay, now join 0.75 with alignment circle. Alignment circle is at this location. What is this location? 25 dry bulb temperature, 25 degree dry bulb temperature and 50% RH. Okay, so this line which we join, it is shown in green. Okay, so wherever ERSHF line is there, related to that I have used green color. Okay, so this will be baseline for ERSHF line. Now what we have to do, we have 0.1 and we have 0.2. So from 0.2, we have to draw a line parallel to baseline for ERSHF line, this green line, okay, passing through 0.2. Wherever it cuts the saturation curve, there we will get point C. Okay, what is ERSHF line? ERSHF line is a line joining room design condition 0.2 and coil ADP 0.C. Okay, so baseline to that we draw parallel from 0.2. Wherever it cut the saturation curve, there we will get point C. Okay, so this is about ERSHF line. Okay, next what we will do? Next we can calculate RSHF. Okay, so again I will go back to the calculation. Now what is the next calculation? RSHF. RSHF is room sensible heat upon room sensible heat plus room latent heat. Okay, so substitute value of room sensible heat, 42 kilowatt upon room sensible heat plus room latent heat. Room latent heat is 12.5 kilowatt. Now you will get room sensible heat factor, which is 0.77. Go back to the psychrometric chart. Go to the sensible heat factor scale, which is there on right side of the psychrometric chart. This is sensible heat factor scale. Now mark on this scale 0.77 value. So this is 0.757677. So this is 0.77 room sensible heat factor. Join it with alignment circle. Alignment circle, it is at 25 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 50% RH. Now this line is called baseline for RSHF. Okay, now once this is done, what you have to do again, okay, this I have shown with the help of orange color. You have to draw a line parallel to baseline, that is orange line, passing through 0.2. Wherever it cuts the saturation curve, there you will get point R. Now here you can see point C and point R, they are very close by. Okay, so I have drawn now RSHF line. Okay, now what is the next data given? Bypass factor is given. Okay, so what equation we have to use now? We don't have this 3c yet. Why? Because even though we have point c, we have point r, we have point 2, we don't have point 4. Okay, or we don't have point 3. So we cannot draw 3c. So what will be our approach? We will use coil bypass factor. What is coil bypass factor? Length 4 dash c. Okay, we are considering which line? Green line. Okay, ERSHF line. There we have to consider 0.4 dash. Whereas 0.4, it will be there on this orange line, RSHF line. Okay, so what is bypass factor? Length C 4 dash upon length C 2. Using scale you have to measure. Okay, then bypass factor is known, C 2 length is known. You will be able to calculate length C4 dash. Once length C4 dash is known, you can get 0.4 dash. Here you can see I have marked this with green point. This point is 0.4 dash. Okay, using scale, you will get 0.4 dash. Mark C4 dash length. You will get 0.4 dash. Now, what will be the next step? From 0.4 dash. Okay. Keep your roller scale parallel to line 1-2. This is line 1-2. From 4 dash, draw parallel to that line, line 1-2. Wherever it cuts the orange line, that is RSHF line, there you will get 0.4. So I'll zoom this part and show you. Here you can see this is line 1-2, and from this green point, which is 4 dash, here you can see I have drawn a pink line. This pink line, it is parallel to this line 1-2. Now wherever this pink line intersects RSHF line, there I will get actual supply point, point number 4. Okay, now once 0.4 we know, 0.4 is known, point C is known, draw a line passing through point C, 0.4, extend it, wherever it cuts line 1-2, there you will get 0.3. Now we have completed the numerical. Okay, so here you can see this is 0.1, it mixes with 0.2 to get 0.3. 3 to 4 is cooling with dehumidification, then 4 is the supply condition. Here 4 is there, that 4 air is supplied to the room and room condition is 0.2. Okay, so this is how you have to solve this numerical. Now what are the questions asked? First question, room ADP. How to find room ADP? Wherever RSHF line intersects the saturation curve, that is room ADP. So if you consider this psychrometric chart, this orange line is baseline, and from 0.2 orange line, it is RSHF line. Wherever it cuts the saturation curve, that is point R. What is the temperature of point R? You have to read here. Okay, this temperature, it is approximately, this is 9 and this is 10. Okay, it is behind 10. Okay, so I have taken that value, I have written the room ADP value, we will see that. It is approximately 9.8. Okay, so room ADP value, here you can see it is 9.8 degrees Celsius. Then what is the second question asked? Temperature of air leaving the conditioner, meaning 0.4. So we have to find TD4. What is TD4? Go back to the chart. TD4. Now here you have to be careful. This point is 0.4 dash and this point is 0.4. You have to read temperature of 0.4, not 4 dash. Okay. So temperature of 0.4, it is 10, 11, 12. 12 degrees Celsius. TD4 is 12 degrees Celsius. So here you can see I have written TD4 value, it is 12 degrees Celsius. Okay, next. So we have completed with this point. Next question. Next question is total quantity of supply air. Okay, now this total quantity of supply air, meaning we have to find supply air is 0.4. Okay, we have to find V dot A4. How to find that? We have to apply energy balance to this room. Energy in M dot dA4 into H4 plus RSH plus RLH equal to energy out, which is M dot dA4 into H2. Same mass flow rate is exiting the room. Okay. Now, here we require H2, H4, RSH, RLH. RSH, RLH is given in the question. H2 we have already read. H4 value we have to read. Okay. So, go back to the psychrometric chart. Here we have 0.4. Okay. I have drawn parallel to the other enthalpy line passing through 0.4. Here we can read enthalpy of 0.4. Okay, what is that enthalpy? This is 30, 31, 32, and this is 32.5. So H4 is 32.5 kilojoule per kg of dry air. So substitute these values in the equation. So here you can see I have applied energy balance to the room. Okay, we have equation written over here as we discussed before. Substitute RSH, RLH, H2, H4. We will get M dot dA4. Okay, after getting M dot dA4, read value of specific volume of 0.4. What is that? Go back to the psychrometric chart. Okay, these are specific volume lines. I have drawn parallel to these lines passing through 0.4. Okay, then roughly divide this in 5 equal parts. Okay, so this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. So approximately I am getting specific volume of 0.4 as 0.82 meter cube per kg. Okay, go back to the numerical. We have found M dot dA4. We have found specific volume of 0.4 from psychrometric chart. Now we can calculate the value of V dot A4, which is supply air quantity. Okay, that will be M dot dA4 into specific volume of 0.4. M dot dA4 value is 3.4 and specific volume of 0.4 it is 0.82. So we can calculate V dot A4. V dot A4 is equal to 2.788 meter cube per second, and if you convert it in meter cube per minute, multiply by 60, you will get 167.28 meter cube per minute. Okay, next question. Coil ADP. What is coil ADP? Wherever line 3C, surface temperature of the coil, and 0.3 intersect, that is coil ADP. Or if you consider point number 2, we have seen ERSHF line. What is that? Point number 2 is connected with C. So there we have to read temperature of point C. So I'll go back to the psychrometric chart. Okay, here you can see this is point C. What is the temperature of point C? This is 9, this is 10. Okay, approximately that point C temperature, it is 9.5 degrees Celsius. So I have written the value of coil ADP as well. Coil ADP is 9.5 degrees Celsius. Okay, one more question is remaining in between. What is that? Temperature of air entering the coil. Okay, what is that temperature of air entering the coil? We have to find TD3. Okay, that is mixing point. 1 and 2 are mixed and we get 0.3. Okay, so go back to the psychrometric chart. Okay, now we have joined, we have to extend point C and 4, draw a line joining C and 4, extend it to line 1, 2. Wherever C4 cuts line 1, 2, there we will get mixing point, point number 3, and that line 3C is called GSHF line. Okay, now we have to read dry bulb temperature of point 3. What is that? This is 25, 26, and it is slightly ahead of 26. Okay, so here you can see this value. This is slightly ahead of 26. So I have written the value here. TD3 is 26.4 degrees Celsius, and coil ADP we have already calculated. So in this way, we have to solve this numerical. Okay, once again in small, I will give you the summary. Then step by step, you have to solve. Okay, so we'll see the summary of this question, what we have done. What we have done in this question, 0.1 data is given, 0.2 data is given. We marked 0.1, we marked 0.2, join 1 and 2. Then after that, draw vertical from 0.1 in downward direction, draw horizontal towards right from 0.2. Wherever they intersect, we get point A. Read H1, HA and H2. Read value of specific volume of 0.1. Now, using this data, we can calculate effective room sensible heat factor. Okay, why? Because OASH, it is equal to m.dA1. How to calculate m.dA1? V.A1 is given, and specific volume we have read. So we will get m.dA1. Then we know enthalpy, HA and H2, specific enthalpy. So we can calculate outside air sensible heat. Then similarly, we can calculate outside air latent heat m.dA1 into H1 minus HA. Bypass factor is 0.15 and room sensible heat is given, room latent heat is given. So we can calculate ERSHF. Then that value was 0.75. We marked 0.75, joined it with alignment circle. That is this baseline for ERSHF line shown by green color. Now draw a line parallel to that baseline passing through 0.2 wherever it cuts the saturation curve, that is coil ADP C. This line is called ERSHF line. Next, we calculated RSHF. What is that? Room sensible heat upon room sensible heat plus room latent heat. That value was 0.77. Join 0.77 with alignment circle. That is this orange line, that is called baseline for RSHF line. Then draw a line passing through 0.2 parallel to baseline of RSHF line. Wherever it cuts the saturation curve, there we will get point R. So we have got point R. Now we have to mark 0.4 dash. How to mark 0.4 dash? By using bypass factor. We cannot mark 0.4 directly. Why? Because we don't have mixing condition. So what we did? We used properties of similar triangle. Okay, triangle C4 dash is similar to triangle C3 2. Okay, so what is the actual bypass factor equation? Length 4C upon length 3C is bypass factor, but because of the similar triangle, I can write length C4 dash upon length C2 is equal to bypass factor. Using that, I got, since bypass factor is known, C2 length is known, I can calculate length C4 dash, then mark C4 dash length, you will get 0.4 dash. Next step is, you have to draw a parallel to line 1-2 passing through 4 dash. Wherever it cuts the orange line, RSHF line, there you will get point number 4. Now this point number 4, it should lie on both RSHF and GSHF line. So RSHF line we have already drawn, on that line itself we have point number 4. Okay, so now we can draw GSHF line. Why? Because we have point C and point 4. So join C4, extend till 1 and 2. Wherever it intersects 1 and 2, that we will get point 3, mixing condition. Now whatever the remaining questions are asked, you can calculate. Okay, room ADP is asked, you can calculate that. Coil ADP is asked, you can read that value. TD4 is asked, you can read this value. TD3 is asked, you can read this value. Okay, using enthalpies, you can calculate volume flow rate of V.A4, supply air. Okay. Now this is about the numerical part. We will stop over here.